guys, and welcome at yourlbb.tv. In this video, I will share 10 tourist traps in Amsterdam, which I think you have to avoid. So if you want to have a different experience, keep watching this video. Number one, cheese. Dutchies love cheese. I love cheese. I eat cheese almost every day. And if you're in Amsterdam and you want to have a cheese experience, don't go to those places in the city center where they have like the plastic looking cheeses in their shopping windows. If you want a real authentic cheese experience in Amsterdam, I would recommend go to Fromagerie Abraham Kef at the Marnixstraat, which is like a great place, super authentic, and they do cheese tastings on Sunday afternoon, which are so much fun to do, and trust me, you don't have to go for dinner afterwards anymore. Number two, tourist attractions. Why would you go to Madame Tussauds or to Body Worlds Expo to look at these wax statues? I don't really get it. If you're looking for something to do, why don't you go for a street art tour where you actually see art from artists all over the world, painted in Amsterdam. And I think it's really cool because the tour is in the city center, so you actually get to see a lot from Amsterdam and also from the Jordan area, which is like the most traditional neighborhood in Amsterdam. And I mean, I love street art and I did the tour like a dozen of times and it's super cool. Number three. Okay, I know everyone wants to go to the Heineken experience, but really, you can drink Heineken almost everywhere in Amsterdam. I would recommend going to one of the craft breweries in Amsterdam. Beer made by local Amsterdam people in small batches, in places that are actually cool. You see a lot of guys with beards there. I recommend going to Oedipus Brewing in Amsterdam North. They actually have their new tasting room. It opened only like a few weeks ago, which is really cool. Or go to Brouwerij het Ei, which is like a really authentic place. It's around for years actually, but they were one of the first to make the beer in Amsterdam, and you can get it at a lot of brew pubs as well, which are also very popular. If you actually want to go to one, go to the Biertuin. I love that place. They have a very nice patio as well, where you can actually drink beer from Brouwerij het Ei. Try it, it's really good. You can also have it there on the draft, so that's actually quite nice. Number four, souvenirs. Why is everyone going home with tulips and wooden shoes? I mean, if you want something cool which is made in Amsterdam or has that really that Amsterdam cool feel, go to places that actually sell products that are made or either designed in Amsterdam. So for example, there's this local goods weekend market which is around at the Foodhalle every week almost, or every other week. You have to check the agenda, but trust me, super cool. There are makers from Amsterdam selling their products there directly. So, I mean, can you think of a better souvenir than that? Or go to Locals, which is a very cool concept store, small store in the city center of Amsterdam. And this girl, she only sells products that are made or designed in Amsterdam as well. It's really, trust me, it's a candy store. I love to go there for gifts for my friends as well. Number five, the red light district. Of course, I understand. You have to go there once in your life when you're in Amsterdam. But as a local, actually, I don't go there that often. And when I go there, I go to these other places, which I think you should know too. So for example, the Oude Kerk is this old church in the red light district where they have the World Press photo every year, but also some very cool other exhibits. So if you go to the red light district, maybe combine it with a visit to the Oude Kerk, or go to one of the very cool restaurants there like Matahari or Anna, which are great for foodies. And yeah, they're actually around in the red light district, but you can see it from a different perspective. All right, number six, fake museums in Amsterdam. And I hear you thinking, fake museums? Yes, fake museums. Like the Tulip Museum, the Wodka Museum, the Bols Museum. Really, these are not really museums, I think, as in museum, museum. These are just like almost store-like museums. So if you want to go to a museum, I would recommend going to FOAM, which is a great photography museum in the heart of Amsterdam, or go to the Museum of Bags and Purses. And that's actually a great tip for the girls. I mean, you will love it. Imagine like bags all over that place. And if you were thinking of going to the Bols Museum or going to the Wodka Museum, go to a real cocktail bar like hiding in plain sight or go to Panache in Amsterdam West, where they have great cocktails as well. And also cuter bartenders, so why don't go there? Number 7. Okay, a canal boat tour. Yes, you definitely have to do that. But you don't have to do like one of those organized canal boat tours that you see all over Amsterdam. Did you know that you can actually rent your own boat? And if you're with a group of friends, it's maybe not even more expensive to do so, but it's definitely more fun. Because you can bring your own booze, you can bring your own food, so bring a picnic basket, or if you actually don't want to bring your own food, you can stop by Blue Spoon on board and you can order food from the restaurant and they will bring it to your boat. Or if you think this is all too adventurous for you, then just take the ferry to Amsterdam North. It's absolutely free. It's a boat ride as well. Not on the canals though, so if you want that experience, maybe you should do one of those canal tours. You can always do it. But in Amsterdam North, the NDSM wharf where you can go, or the I Square is really cool, and there's a lot of things to do there, and yeah, Amsterdam North is fun anyway. So number 8. The squares in Amsterdam. Amsterdam is full of squares, but please avoid going for drinks or anything like that to the Rembrandtplein, Leidseplein and Damrak. Really. It's, I mean, full of touristy places, and it wouldn't give you the local feel. So if you want to go for drinks on a square, I know where to go. Go for example to the Hugo de Grootplein in Amsterdam West, which is a great square with all cool places there, and yeah, you will meet a lot of locals and it will really give you the local neighborhood feel of Amsterdam West. Or go to Amsterdam East to the Beukenplein, which is also a nice square, a lot of cool hipster style places opened up there on the last few years. Or for the real authentic Amsterdam feel, go to the Noordermarkt, which actually also has a very cool vintage market on Monday, or a farmer's market on Saturday. So it's a really cool place to go for drinks and for dinner. Number 9. Ooh, like this. Clubs. I get the question so often, and where do I go for clubbing in Amsterdam? And trust me, it's not on those squares that I mentioned earlier. There are really only the tourist style discos or clubs. And actually keep a close eye on your little black book, because Trouw, the most famous techno club in Amsterdam, will open again somewhere soon. But until then, go clubbing at, for example, The Warehouse, which is this very dark industrial place far out of the city center, but actually really cool. Check it out. Club Closure, which is at the Rozengracht, which means it's basically in the city center and is like this techno basement, also really cool. Or go to Radion, which is in Amsterdam West. It's a bit more out of the city center, but it's really, it gives you this almost Berlin feel of going to a club. It's really cool. Or go to the Marktkantine, which is actually, it's an old food warehouse. So it's a warehouse style kind of club, and they actually get their own program this fall, which is gonna be very cool. Number 10. Markets in Amsterdam. I mean, there are so many cool local food markets and things like that. I think the Albert Cuyp market is of course the most famous market in Amsterdam. You have to see it once in your life. You have to eat a stroopwafel there. But there are other cool markets as well, so go for example to the Foodhalle, which is a nice food market. Go to the Eihalle, which is the largest flea market in Amsterdam. You can go treasure hunting there, it's really cool. Or go to one of the Sunday markets, which is really fun to do on Sunday, because, I mean, what do you do on Sunday when you're on a city trip anyway? So go for example to the Sunday market, to the neighbor food market, or to the Pure Markt, which is all about organic local produce. It's really cool, and they're always in parks, so it's very relaxed vibe, and yeah, rain or shine, they're there. I hope you liked this video and that I inspired you to discover another side of Amsterdam. If you liked it, thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel not to miss another video about Amsterdam, and see you in the next video.